everybody.
Happy New Year.
And a Happy New Year. Can you say Happy New Year?
Happy New Year.
Excellent. So this is our Lunar New Year assembly. We have a lot of great presentations today. We're going to start with a Pledge of Allegiance. Constantine and Ethan are going to lead us.
Yeah. sweep away bad luck and decorated with red paper cutouts, which symbolize good fortune. They gathered for a lavish reunion dinner on New Year's Eve, featuring dishes like dumplings and fish for prosperity. Fireworks light up the sky to ward off evil spirits, and children receive red envelopes filled with money for luck. People also wear new clothes and get new haircuts to welcome the new year.
In South Korea, Lunar New Year is celebrated with family gatherings and traditional customs. People pay respects to their ancestors by bowing and offering food and ancestral gravesties. Families gather for a special meal, including dishes like dukguk, which is a rice cake soup that symbolizes good luck and longevity. Children receive seban, a traditional bow from their elders, and are given money in lucky envelopes called pocket money. Throughout the holiday, there are also games, activities, and performances to mark the beginning of the new Lunar New Year.
This past July, New York celebrated South Korea at the Rockefeller Center. Now, we will hear from Rhea Yi as she will be performing a Korean Lunar New Year song along with Dr. Park. Let's enjoy it!
That means Happy New Year in Japanese. Although in Japan, we stopped celebrating the Lunar New Year's 150 years ago, we do celebrate New Year's at the same time as we celebrate here in the US on January 1st. So we wanted to share a little bit about how Japanese people celebrate New Year's. And so the first thing we want to talk about is
Visiting the shrines or temples. One of the common traditions in Japan is visiting the shrine or temple. It predicts your luck of the year. Many people have a fortune telling thing called omikuji. Omikuji is either bad luck or good luck. When you have bad luck, you're able to leave it at the temporary shrine, and you're able to start your year with good luck.
Here are some of the traditional foods that we eat for New Year's. The first thing is omochi, which you don't see it on the picture here, but you will see on the next slide. That's a Japanese sticky rice that we typically eat with the New Year food. The second thing is osechirori, which is a traditional Japanese New Year feast, which you see on the top. We serve it in a elaborate box. The third is the soba noodles that you see on the bottom. We eat this noodle the day before New Year's to cut the bad luck from the year before and start fresh for the following year.
Another one of the foods is ozoni. Ozoni is a Japanese soup that comes with mochi, fish cakes, and any other ingredients. Another one is senzai. Senzai is a sweet bean mochi, which is often eaten in New Year's.
We also give what is called the otoshidama, which is the gift of the New Year. It's a monetary gift that is given from adult to the children.
Now we'll show a little video that shows how much otoshidama is important to little children.
It's New Year, which means money, which equals otoshidama.
I wonder what I should give you guys.
Got any ideas?
Money? Otoshidama.
Here you go.
Yay!
Play around during New Year's.
This is Hanetsuki, which we'll show you in this little video.
That is the wooden paddle that the two people were playing with, and the shuttlecock is what they were hitting. And we also do takuage, which is on the right top. Basically, it's flying kite.
We also do fukuwarai, which is arranging facial parts while being blindfolded. Another one is karuta, which is basically Japanese playing cards.
Happy New Year. Akemashite.
Some traditions before the Lunar New Year. Some common activities before the Lunar New Year. Is visit your relatives, wearing new clothes, cleaning the house, and cooking. Popular food during the Lunar New Year is dumplings, fish, sticky rice cake, and hot pot.
Traditional activities during the New Year are line dance, firecrackers, visiting the temple and wearing red. But the best part of the New Year are red envelopes.
So I will be talking about the Lunar New Year food in Taiwan. So dinner is the most important meal. Usually occurring on Lunar New Year Eve. Everybody gathers, no matter how far they are, as a reunion. That's why hot pot is usually used, like this right here. because it makes everybody sit around the table together. So some dishes are more important than others during Lunar New Year, like whole fish, because it symbolizes an abundance of food and money. So this is Gai Choi, and it symbolizes long life. Another popular food is chicken and duck, but it is bad luck to cut off their heads, so most of the time you'll see them with their heads on. Happy 新年快乐! Happy New Year!
Abundance, Yu Sheng, is interpreted as
another trend is word yishang, meaning an increase in abundance. Therefore, yishang is considered a symbol of prosperity and victory. So the prosperity toss, the dish is a symbol on a plate for the prosperity toss, in which vegetables are first beautifully laid out on a plate, which auspicious sayings are uttered when the final ingredients are added. Then the diners will toss the ingredients in the air like this, with more auspicious wishes. Some of the desserts we eat in Malaysia for the New Year are pineapple tarts, which like yishang, symbolize prosperity, and love letters or kwikapi, which used to symbolize romantic interest in one's partner, but now symbolizes love between friends and family. So thank you and Happy New Year.
Today we're going to be talking about Lunar New Year in Thailand. So for the introduction, Lunar New Year isn't just a national holiday in Thailand. However, it's widely celebrated in Thailand. So people take at least one day off from work to enjoy time with family and friends. And red is also the official Lunar New Year color in Thailand. How is Lunar New Year celebrated in Thailand? So for day one, it's the buying day, where people go out and buy stuff for praying and for family members and friends to show respect towards them. Day two is the praying day. They cook meats and arrange them in places in the house for the different gods. After that, the family gets together, eat, and children get money in red envelopes called ang bao. It's a noisy day, as after praying, they light firecrackers and let the gods know. Day three is rest. People go out to eat and no one does any work. We visit our elders and perform a blessing ritual. We ask for forgiveness for whatever we could have done wrong to them and finish with pouring scented water over their hands. They in turn forgive us and give us blessings.
People in Thailand also celebrate Songkran, which is celebrated on April 13 in a span of 3 days. The first day, they give a blessing ritual to their elders and they also pour scented jasmine water on their hands, and their elders forgive them and bless them with their blessings. The second and third day, they bless each other with water and die at water fights. What the water fight symbolizes. It brings good luck and it encourages the rains for the harvesting, and towns and cities put Buddha images around for people to rinse them. Temples during Songkran, people go and offer food and flowers to the Buddhist monks as a way of showing respect to the Sangha. That people chant for inner peace and spiritual well-being, and they also bring sand to build stupas, which represents the Buddhist concept of enlightenment. Some traditional foods are tom yum soup, which is a spicy coconut soup with lime and green grass. Pad Thai was a stir-fried noodles and mango sticky rice, refreshing dessert made of coconut milk.
The best places to celebrate Lunar New Year in Thailand. First is Yawaraj, Bangkok. The biggest celebrations take place in Yawaraj, which is the Chinatown of Bangkok. Second is Rawrot Market, Chiang Mai. Rawrot Market in the historic town of Chiang Mai is where you should be. The streets are lined with food and souvenir stalls. Thank you. Happy New Year.
Bella will now perform a cello piece.
Thank you.
Now, to conclude our assembly, the 8th grade Mandarin students will perform a crosstalk talking show named Learning Chinese.
Happy Lunar New Year!
Happy Lunar New Year!
singers, all the students who told us about their home traditions. And our eighth graders also did a fantastic job teaching us some Mandarin words. I also want to give a big round of applause to our fantastic MCs, so Eliza and Richard. We're going to need 2 7th graders to take over for them next year. And of course, I would like to bring up here Mrs. Guo, Mrs. Chen, come on up, so that we can really give you a big round of applause for teaching our students about the Chinese language and culture and preparing for this assembly. Thank you so much. Let's give them a big round of applause.
We truly appreciate all of your contributions in making this Lunar New Year Assembly a success.
A huge thank you to our Lower School Mandarin students and heritage speakers. Your hard work has truly paid off, especially to my fourth grade Mandarin friends who memorized the challenging song lyrics. I am incredibly proud of you all. Special thank you to our Lower School homeroom teachers, Dr. Glennon, Dr. Park, Mrs. Chilianis, piano teacher Ms. Chong, guitar teacher Mr. Keo Lee, for their flexibility and unwavering support.
To our Asian heritage students, with dedication to interview your families, our grandparents, or even cousins, and sharing your culture has enriched us. And to our 8th grade Mandarin students, your effort in preparing for the talk show has been admirable. I am immensely proud of all your progress.
A big shout out to our lab students, Mr. Oz and the Menace team for ensuring the smooth running of the assembly.
And also to our PM volunteers who generously dedicate their time to organize cultural activities for our students in the reception room for the whole morning.
And last, but certainly not the least, a heartfelt thank you to our Dr. Zhao, Dr. Slinger, and Mrs. Lyons for their continued support in making this event possible at Buffy every year. Your dedication leaves a lasting impact on our students, and we are the world citizens.